Good morning, everybody. We're going to do a little Dutch oven cooking. We're going to do up some Mountain Man breakfast, my version of it. So it'll be a little different than everybody else's, but same as some people, I suppose. I lined up some Dutch ovens just to give you an idea of different sizes. You got 10-inch, 12, 14 deep, and a 16. We're going to use a 10-inch today, but good thing about these Dutch ovens, you can stack them all. Get some coals going. Coals here, coals here, coals here, and you can stack them right on up. I'm not going to stack them all. I don't know if this table will hold all the weight in one spot, but then the 10-inch on top. But you can cook for a lot of people with just a few ovens here. So they're really nice. This lip's for is to keep the charcoal on there so you can stack them on up and get her going. So anyway, we're going to start with the 10. Not start with, but this is what we're going to do our Mountain Man breakfast in. There's only three of us eating this morning. So, and on your heat, when you're going to fry, you want to just throw some coals down, and then we can get some good frying going. But if you want to do a Dutch oven where you got about 350 degrees in it, then what you want to do is 10 inch, you would take two or three away, 10 on the bottom, 10 on top, then take three away from the bottom, make it 7 and add them to the top. So it'd be 7 and 13, and that would give you about a 350 degree oven. So we're going to fry, so we're going to get more than that down there so we can start frying some bacon up for our breakfast. But we got potatoes, garlic, bacon, onion, lots of cheese. We love cheese in this family, and some eggs. And that's about all there is in this dish. So we'll get the bacon going here. Once the bacon's done, we're going to pull the bacon out, put it on a paper plate with some paper towels, and then save it for the end of the dish with the cheese. So we'll get this going, and about halfway through this, we'll fire it back up and show you how it's going once it's frying. See you in a minute. All right, folks, we got bacon going pretty good. We got to put a few more coals underneath there because of the, see the fog, it's pretty humid today. So we got to put a few more coals under there to get a good fry going on it. We got extra briquettes going in here. So whenever you're out in the great outdoors and you want to cook and hunting and camping, you never know if it's going to be foggy or humid or it's raining or whatever. So you always want to have extra charcoal on the go. So when you want to add more heat, you can. You always take some away. But if you have to add a bunch, you don't have none ready, then you're going to be in trouble. You're going to be a lot longer to get a meal for your family going. So we got some extra ones going here, and it is a little chilly today. It's probably, I don't know, I think it's about 10 o'clock in the morning, and it's pretty foggy still. So we're going to keep frying our bacon. And all right, everybody, we got bacon done. We're going to go ahead and pull that out, put our potatoes in, fry them up. You can do this Mountain Man breakfast any way you want. I like doing the bacon. Pull it out, save it for the end of it, and I'll show you what we're going to do. But some people take and do the bacon, put the potatoes in, get them frying, and then they put the bacon back in there and they mix that all up. And then when they get the eggs and everything in, they just close it up and then leave it and let it set and bake that way. But I keep mixing it all the way through this deal. Your potatoes, they like lots of seasoning, so don't be afraid to put some seasoning on there. Some potatoes will suck up a lot of flavor. We'll just go ahead and stir this up and get these frying up. When they're almost done frying, then we'll add the eggs in it, and then we'll keep doing this until all the eggs are cooked, mixing it up, And then mushroom. And then we'll put cheese and the bacon back on top. Believe it or not, that's only 3 potatoes. Those are big old potatoes here in Idaho. And we got 1 onion. Got about a pound of cheese, maybe a little over a pound of cheese. We won't use all the onions. Speaking of that, I need to put the onion and garlic in. We'll put some onion in there. Thanks, honey, for reminding me. We got garlic. Yeah, I'd been in trouble if we forgot this stuff. You get all that in there and let that all cook together, and that'd make it a lot better dish. It's a good thing about this, you can add whatever you want. There's times we add peppers to it, we add pork to it. And that's what we like to do. I don't know if we'll do it today, but pull it out and eat it as a breakfast burrito. Put it on some soft shell tacos, tortillas, and then just eat it that way. Or put it in a bowl and eat it that way. So that's a good thing about this Dutch oven cooking. You can do it absolutely any way you want, and there's no right way or wrong way. Just because my way is different than yours doesn't make it right and doesn't make it wrong. So anyway, we'll hopefully people that are experienced at Dutch oven cooking can learn a little bit, but people that aren't experienced can learn a lot and not be afraid to go out there and start cooking with them. You can cook them with it in the house, you can cook them out here, you can use wood, you can use charcoal, you can use propane. They're so versatile that every household ought to have some. And my favorite, since I'm on that, is Lodge. That white stuff on there is just coconut oil, by the way, you guys. Lodge is my favorite Dutch oven. Cast irons, fry pans, we got fry pans, all different sizes. I got a fry pan that big around, cast iron. My 16-inch Dutch oven, I got 3 of those. But Camp Chef makes one too. They make Dutch ovens, and they're good. Nothing wrong with them, but I like Lodge. I'm a fan of Lodge, so I've only got 1 Camp Chef. The rest of my Dutch ovens are Lodge. My fry pans are Lodge. And I've got probably, Dutch oven-wise, I've got 10 or 13 different Dutch ovens. I got 3 of these. I got some 14 deeps, 14 shallow, 12s, 10s. I got a bunch of them. So anyway, all right, folks, we're going to talk a little bit about covering. The wife just asked me if I wanted to cover the Dutch oven. I told her no, we don't want to cover it when you're doing a lot of onions, potatoes, unless you want the moisture. I don't want it in this dish, so I'm not going to cover it. I'm going to let everything evaporate out of it. So when I add my eggs on there, I don't have to drain nothing off. But if I was going to, like the chicken dish I do, I cover it because I want the moisture in there so that helps cook everything together, but we don't pull everything out. So anyway, we'll leave it open. That way it'll evaporate off and we don't end up with half inch of moisture down in the bottom boiling and steaming stuff up. So I like it fried. So we're just going to leave it uncovered, keep the heat to it, fry it up so we don't get a bunch of moisture in the bottom. So anyway, see you in a minute. All right, everybody, I just wanted to give you a little bit of a scenery picture here. I love this Idaho mountain, great outdoors. Fog's starting to lift up a little bit so we can see some scenery. Got the neighbors down there working. I don't know if you can hear that or not, but it's beautiful up here north of Boise. And there's our other Dutch ovens and our potatoes cooking up, getting all fried up. I think I'll add a little more heat to that. Those are getting ready to go. All right, folks, we'll see you in a minute. All right, everybody, it's been right about an hour frying potatoes. It's They're coming along nice. I think they're done. We're gonna add some eggs to it. And get it finished off for us. But I wanted to touch a little bit on cooking in the great outdoors, because you never know your atmosphere. So, you know, 1 minute it's sunny, 1 minute it's foggy, raining. So you want to give yourself plenty of time, because you can't rush Dutch oven cooking, dude. The more you try to rush it, the farther behind you're going to get. So you definitely want to have it planned out good, to where you can have plenty of time to get it done, so you can get it ate. You're not rushed. Nobody likes to be rushed. So, but we got about, well, like I said earlier, 3 big potatoes, half an onion, about 6 cloves of garlic. So I'm just going to put enough eggs in there to where it looks like it's a good combination. I don't know how many we're going to put in there yet, but where it's a good mixture. It's turning out to be a beautiful day in the great outdoors here. Tell it's warming up, because we've got a couple of wasps buzzing around us here a little bit. Another thing I wanted to kind of touch on, this is a 10-inch Dutch oven. It's not very heavy. When you fill it up with food, it gets a little heavier. And then, you know, you do that 16-inch Dutch oven. Dutch oven alone is probably 30, 40 pounds, and then you fill it up with a bunch of food, and next thing you know, you're having a heck of a time carrying it, packing it where it needs to go safely. So you want to make sure you do it somewhere to where you might not have to pack it. Tonight we're going to do a beef pepper steak type dinner in the Dutch oven. But I think I'm going to do it up on the deck, because once I do that, all that fluid and moisture in there, probably use that 14-inch one, and it's pretty heavy. Instead of packing it up the stairs, taking a chance of spilling it on myself or all over, I'll do it up there closer to the house. And so when you're out at the campfire or whatever, you want to make sure you got a nice setup, so you don't have to pack it around the campsite to serve it. So we'll let these eggs cook up, and then we'll finish it off. We're going to put the cheese on it, and then we'll put the bacon on, and then we'll just let that melt. And then once that melts and this dish is done, we're ready to eat. So this 10-inch Dutch oven, it's not very big, but as you can see, there's a lot of food in here. This probably feeds 6-8 people pretty easy. 3 of us are going to put a dent in it, though. But we're not portion control people, but I guess we should be, but we're not. We eat it because it's good, and we eat a lot of it. So anyway, we'll come back and see you when this is about done and we're getting ready to put the cheese on it. See you in a minute. All right, folks, I was just going to put some more heat on here and thought might as well show you guys, but you get so much charcoal built down there, if you just keep adding it, the middle ones can't breathe. So what you want to do is you want to kind of push all this ashes out of the way, just push them to the outside there. They got some more coals ready to roll here, so we'll just get a new bed going. That way the center ones can breathe and they stay nice and hot. Like I said, if you get a big old pile of them in there, and then they can't breathe and they go out, and makes it forever for your breakfast to get done or your dinner. So I want to make sure it's all open underneath there, so they can get their oxygen, so they can stay lit, stay hot. And my lid lifter, it's also a handle lifter. And then that way, it'll cook a lot faster. And you ain't got the wife yelling at you that she's hungry and the kids barking at you that they're starving to death. So we'll add some more heat to it and we're gonna get this dish done. So we'll see you in a minute again. All right, folks, it's only been about 15 minutes. The eggs didn't take long after I redone my coals, got the ashes out of the way so they could breathe and get hot again. You can see it's done. It's ready for cheese. Bacon on top of this thing. And we can eat and be merry. We all love to eat, right? I know I love to eat and it shows. I don't know if we'll use all the cheese, but we're going to put a good amount on here and spread it out. Let her melt down, and then while that's melting down, keep that bottom heat on it, or maybe even pull it off. And that'll put a good brown crust. And my mouth is watering already, folks. On the bottom of that. So, I don't know about you guys, but I like the flavor of that browned eggs, potatoes mixture. And we'll put this bacon on top. And probably not going to take long for this to melt down in. We're even going to throw the lid back on to keep the heat in. Hopefully the cheese don't stick to the top. Yeah, push that down a little bit so we can clear that lid. We don't pull all of our cheese out when I lift that lid up a little bit. Alright folks, I'm going to move that over, I think. That's pretty hot under there after I done that with the ashes. So we're going to move that over to here. Push that right there. We're going to let it finish real quick. So anyway, it's about done. We're about there. I really don't know what to talk about other than my neighbor down there cutting up his firewood for the winter. Winter's coming on. So we're all getting ready for the big snow. Hopefully we get 8 feet of snow this year. I love it. My wife won't love it, but I'd love it. That's what I'm praying for. So anyway, we're going to get this finished up and we'll be back in a minute. It'll be about 10-15 minutes for that to melt down in there, I think. I might even throw a couple coals on top to help her along. So, you know, just keep it running. We're just going to throw some up here right now. We'll get some top heat going. I don't know what all you guys like to do, but we love to cook and eat in this family. My wife, she works down in the city, and she doesn't have a lot of time to cook, so my dad does a lot of the cooking up here. I like to come up and give him a break and do some cooking. I cook a little different than my dad, but my dad's a great cook too. He does excellent soups, and he does potato salad to just blow your mind. Potato soup is one of his specialties. He loves cooking potato soup. In one of these episodes, we'll do a potato soup in the Dutch oven, do some chili, and we'll do some, maybe do some ribs and some desserts, some cobblers, upside down cake, and a dump cake. And there's no end to what you can do in a Dutch oven. But you do like this, about 8 people, you can feed a whole army with a couple of 16-inch Dutch ovens. So anyway, if you've got a big family, you can buy a couple of them. If you've got a small family, you can buy a couple small ones, and you can do your dinner and do your dessert right here all at the same time. And then when you're done eating, dessert's ready to go, some cold ice cream or whatever you got. You can do biscuits in it, you can do dinner rolls in them, you can do bread in them, cornbread, sourdough, whatever you want to do in them, you can do in a Dutch oven. They're a completely amazing tool to have in the house. And then if we ever, hopefully, God willing, we don't ever have a catastrophe to where you don't have power, you don't have nothing, then all you got is your cast iron to cook and feed your family. Like if the government goes south or if we get a mudslide and we can't get out of here and we lose all of our power and whatnot, my family would be fed because we can cook with the Dutch oven. So hopefully you guys can learn and get some Dutch ovens, get practicing up, and then you guys will be self-sufficient in a big catastrophe too. And then we won't have to rely on that government for everything. That would be the ultimate goal. Oh yeah, he's melting right down there. Like I said before, I get impatient. I'm hungry. It smells excellent. The more you open that thing up, the longer it takes. And I know that rule, but you just can't help it sometimes. But if you keep it closed up, know your times. I know it takes 15 minutes to melt that cheese or there's about. So anyway, it's nice to open it up and look at it and see what it's doing. But the more you do it, the longer it takes to do your final product. So, all right. Well, we'll give it a minute, and I'm running out of things to talk about. So we'll see you in a minute. All right, folks. I think we're done. Knock these off here. It's nice to have a little wisp brush too, if you're going to be doing this. Especially for a display, you can take your coals off, then you whisk off your ashes. You can give it a blow and blow them off, and then put a little coconut oil or any kind of oil on there and make her nice and shiny black for if you're going to cook for a bunch of people and it's going to impress people. That'll be good, and then you get rid of all these ashes on there, and then you can make it all nice and black again like the side. So this is what she turned out to be. That sure looks good, huh, folks? I think it looks great. We're going to push a little bit up. I don't have a fork to taste it in front of you today, but kind of make a mess on this first one that we'll get out of here. That's kind of what you get. Like I said before, you can take and put it in tortilla, make some salsa and tortilla and sour cream on it, and have yourself a breakfast burrito, or you can eat it just like this with salsa, ketchup, whatever you like. It's plain too. It's excellent the way it is plain. So if you like what you've seen, please comment, like the page, please share it with your friends, and comment on what you like to cook, or if you'd like to see me cook something special, you can comment on there, and I'll see what I can do to make it for you. So anyway, here in the great outdoors, thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it. See you later.